How are you? I'm Peri Lyons, New York City celebrity psychic. I just got back from the gala at Tibet House, and it was very star-studded, and I wish you could have been there with me, but you were in spirit. They auctioned off my psychic reading services for Tibet House is the Dalai Lama's charity. So I made a couple of thousand for Tibet House and for support, most of all for support of mothers in Tibet. Anyway, so happy to be here. Now it's a Venus retrograde right now. So maybe a great time to, if somebody's coming back into your life from the past, to maybe think about giving them another chance. Maybe not the best time in the world to start something. Give it till like November 1st, around there. This Venus retrograde, I know it seems silly to say that like great whirling lumps of rock in the sky care about what we're doing on Tuesday, but my experience is astrology is accurate. Don't know why. It doesn't make any sense to me, but there you go. So I've got a little poem I wrote that I'd like to share with you because I've been getting a lot of clients sort of obsessing over somebody who doesn't maybe return the feelings. We've all done that. I've done it. I have a degree in that, right? Not anymore, but so here's a little poem I wrote for all of you called Everyone Loves Me But You. That plastic surgeon on Park Avenue wants to know if he can take me to a do. He's mighty handsome. He can make me pretty too. Everyone loves me but you. That brilliant artist wants to paint me in the nude. His paintings hang in the Metropolitan, dude. To refuse to be a nude muse to genius would be rude. But I do. I stay home at night and paint my toenails blue because everyone loves me but you. You and I see movies. You and I have dinner. You and I take long walks in the park. You want to do at night what most people do in daytime. I want to do what folks do after dark. Can we just park? The plastic surgeon wants to take me to the Philharmonic. The painter wants to fly me to the Louvre. And while I dog your footsteps, though I'm almost catatonic, the writer gives me first editions of his entire Louvre. Wait a second. I'm rethinking this. Thursday? Oh, I'd love to, but I'll be at Lincoln Center. Friday, I would love to, but I'm posing in the nude. Saturday, we're going on a literary bender. And Sunday, gosh, I hope I don't sound rude. But for the next few years, there's just no time that's free. Because everyone loves you. Yes, every girl loves you. I wish you all the best. But you hit pause, so get some rest. I know how hard you studied, but you never took the test. So be free. And you have a happy life, but you won't have me as a wife. Because everyone loves you but me. Yes! So, if you haven't guessed, that poem is about reclaiming your power as a woman. We don't have to, you know, the treasure doesn't have to do the hunting. So, that's my little share for you kids today. Quickly just share one last thing. Jennifer, if you don't mind waiting 2 minutes. I'll be with you in one sec. I just want to reveal some secrets of the universe, you know, as one does. So the universe is very big, very mysterious. There are some scientists, however, who claim that the universe only looks mysterious because it's far away and because it's very, very dark. And these scientists claim that the universe is not actually full of mystery. It's actually just full of math and is only pretending to be mysterious because it didn't get good grades in calculus. They also claim that the universe is 500,000 billion years old, whereas the universe claims to be 39. As a professional mystic, the universe has revealed some of its deepest, darkest secrets to me. Now, for the first time, the universe real secrets revealed. One, here Here are a few of the universe's most closely guarded secrets. One, the universe wet the bed until it was 5 million years old. Two, the universe's favorite game is Worlds with Friends. Three, occasionally, the universe giggling madly will spell out really dirty words across the sky using leftover stars. So far, no one's noticed. Four, the universe occasionally whispers the following phrase to itself. Hey, I'm a meaniverse. Five, the universe likes toast, but it's hard to get it delivered. More often than not, it arrives either stone cold or too far in the future to eat. Six, the universe thinks Saturn is frankly a little showy. The rings? A little pompous. The universe thinks Saturn's up to something. But what? The universe has many secrets. One time it fell asleep and some galaxies fell sideways. It put them back, but the universe really hopes that the duct tape holds. Ten, the universe knows your home address and it wants to send you brownies. Somehow it never finds the time. Good night, says the universe. I have told you some secrets. Now, can you turn off the Hubble for a day or two so I can take a shower? P.S. The age of the universe is another mystery. I've solved this one quite easily by the simple expedient of making it up. It's okay. It's quantum. Okay. Thanks for listening. And we're going to take Jennifer. And how are you doing in Florida, Jennifer?
I'm doing well. How are you, Peri?
Good. Has the storm affected you in any way?
No, it's up north away from me, but we're preparing to respond to it if need be.
Okay. I think you're going to be okay. I'm just glad you're all prepared. Now, just tell me your birthday. You don't have to do the date. I don't ask girls to do that. So, but what day is your birthday?
It's July 24th.
Oh, cool. That's kind of Leo. Okay. All right. Do you have a specific question or do you want me to just do a...
I think you could just do a general.
Do you do something that has to do with healing? Because you have a healing ability and you have caretaking talents. So do you...
Currently in my career, no, but in... But I'm aspiring, yes.
What are you aspiring for, too?
I'm working on opening a life coaching practice.
Oh, that's great. Okay, terrific. Because my guides were saying nurse, not nurse. I'm like, oh, that's helpful. Thank you, people. But you have a real healing ability, and you have an ability. I'm very glad you're doing the life coaching, and here's why. Because in your family growing up, you know, all families are a little effed up. Maybe yours a little bit more than most. And I think in the past, you were punished for your ability to see and tell the truth. So for you to be doing something in which you're acknowledging the value of your own truth, what you observe and what you see about other people, sorry, that makes my hands look really big, is fantastic. And the fact, I think you're going to be a practicing life coach probably within 9 months to a year. I would stay with your day job. You do something administrative? Do you manage people?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. You're a good manager. Occasionally, people criticize you for being for not letting them get away with stuff. But screw that. Ignore them. You're very good. You're a very good manager. And because you have that talent for seeing the truth, and you have two kids? No, that's all right. I'm a little confused about the kids situation. You won. I think there was a possibility for another, so I'm just going to leave that there. Your kid is pretty special. I mean, I know, like, all moms think their kids are special, but your kid is going to, I think, has maybe been labeled with some sort of label, but whatever that label is, they're wrong. This kid has the ability to sort of multitask, like, intellectually. So this kid can sort of think in new ways. And I think that your kid is going to, excuse me, saying you're a kid. What, first I got a girl and then I got a boy. So sorry, I'm having a gender, my guides are being gender free. I'm going to go with is it a girl?
It is a girl, and they are very correct.
Yeah. So don't let anybody tell her or you that there's anything wrong with her, because what she has is the ability to look at, to think in a way people aren't thinking quite yet. And that's going to get her really far. She's also really pretty. I'm just like, sorry, I hate to be shallow, but so I'm totally on the side of you doing the life coach thing. It validates, you're going to validate yourself and others. You're going to do a lot of good healing, and I'm going to take the next guess, but you've just come through a lot of CREP and you're finally on your feet. Fake it till you make it. If you don't feel confident, just act confident and people will believe you. Trust me on this one. So, all right, you're going to do, I'm so excited about your future. I'm just so excited. So call back and let us know how you're doing. And by us, I mean me. Okay.
Will do. Thank you.
Thank you. And send me your life coach thing. I'd like to refer people to you eventually. Okay.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
All right, dear. Okay. So, our next person is from, is it Sosa Marie?
Yeah, hi, dear. Pronounced Sue as in
Sue, oh, sorry.
Susie Q.
Oh, that's cute. I like that.
Yeah.
How are you?
And I'm Tanya, all right. How are you?
I'm great, thank you. Love the name. Is it, do you say Tanya or Tanya?
Tanya,
okay. Pretty.
Yeah.
I like that. It sounds like a sexy spy name.
Like what? So,
it sounds like a sexy spy name.
Oh, well, thank you.
No, it's great.
I'll take
it's
that.
Really cool here. Yeah, you deserve it. So,
hey.
Seems like there's a lot of family stuff going on around you, and you're not being pulled in to the normal family BS. Am I right about that?
Yes.
Cool. Oh, and tell me your birthday.
May 26, 1979.
Oh, you little Gemini, you. Oh, yeah. 1979. Let's see. I'm trying to remember what the Chinese. I'll remember what your Chinese astrological animal is soon. But oh, I love Geminis.
Goat, maybe.
Oh yeah, it is the goat. Yeah, Gemini goat.
I had to think about that for a minute.
I should have gotten it for you. So, it feels like a specific question. I mean, I can tell you some stuff about yourself that over the last 2 months, things have suddenly started to get better. And I'm noticing this with a lot of evolved people, especially women, that suddenly there's light at the end of the tunnel, and for once, it's not an oncoming train, okay? But it feels like there's a specific question you'd like to ask. So, talk to me, sugar.
About my work, there's a lot of...
politics.
There's a lot of politics. There's a lot of shadiness going on, and it's impacting me in negative ways. And so, I'm trying to figure out...
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Well, first, I was just going to invoke Archangel Michael energy around you.
Okay.
If you text, if you send me your number, I can text you some, I do angelic artwork. So I'm happy to, or maybe I'll post an Archangel Michael thing on my page for you to download and print out. So first I'm just going to ask Archangel. Yeah. It's, you know, I was brought up Jewish and Episcopalian, but and Buddhist, but Archangel Michael is the real deal. So if you invoke him for just a minute every morning and have an artwork of him to sort of look at, he sorts stuff out. It is amazing. So you're surrounded. You have integrity. I'm sorry. I wish I could change that for you. I know from personal experience it's an expensive luxury to have. But if you have integrity, you can't change it, and you have integrity.
Thank you.
You're welcome, but you know I'm right.
Yeah.
And
I wish sometimes I didn't, but I do. So I can't drop down to other people's level.
No.
As much as I want to some days, I can't, but.
No, it would be great if you could. Not possible for you. But, I mean, you can't even lie well or at all.
No, I can't. I really wish I could, but I can't. The guilt would eat me.
Carolyn, I'd be so much more successful if I didn't break out in hives.
Totally would.
So, but ultimately, integrity pays off. So you're fine. There is a job in your immediate vicinity where they're looking. Oops, I seem to have frozen there. There. Oh, good. There's a job in your immediate vicinity where they're looking
for
you. What?
I missed it. Cut out for a second. What was that?
There's a job in your immediate vicinity. Where, like, within a 20-mile radius, where they're looking for somebody like you. And I believe that if you do, like, a minimum of telling maybe friends that you might be interested in a new job, or if you do a minimum of research and sending out resumes, you have some pretty impressive experience and skills. You just do. And I don't think you're giving yourself
a job that I'm interested in at the moment.
I would go after it and do it before Mercury goes retrograde. Because I want you out of this. I mean, I shouldn't say this unless I'm prepared to pay your bills. Which when I'm a millionaire, I'll be happy to. But there's a job looking for you, and you can feel that. You're very intuitive, girl.
Very. Learning how to trust it is my issue.
What's that?
It's my issue is learning how to trust my intuition more.
We'll be talking about that in future shows, but right now I'm going to say, check in with your gut. The next show is all about like 10 minutes, how to access your intuition and trust it. The next 5 minutes will be demonstrating how to make balloon animals. So I think don't tune in for one, tune in for the other. So there's a job looking for you, and you know that, and you know that your time at the other job, done. Those are not people who you should be around. They don't deserve you.
No, they don't.
And I don't think it's doing you any good to be in an environment of people who play fast and loose with the truth, which is what they do.
Yeah.
And there's some accounting stuff going on. There's people. There's just a lot of lying going on around you. That is not.
There is.
A lot.
Yeah.
And a lot. It's from people who don't know that they're lying, which is kind of the scary thing. They kind of can't tell the difference anymore. So
isn't that sad?
Yeah, but I don't care about them, so really, I care about you.
In general, it's sad that people don't even recognize when they're lying, because they're so used to lying all the time that they've convinced themselves that what they're saying is the truth.
You know, my friend Katarina recently said, that every time you lie or you defend a lie, It's like a little piece of your soul just sort of shrugs and gives up. It's not good for your soul. And so I don't want you around those kind of people because I already know you're a really cool girl, woman, person.
Thank you.
Well, you are. You tell... I trained with an FBI expert in voice modalities. And there's...
Oh, that's true.
And you can tell a huge amount about somebody by their voice.
Very.
And yeah, no, it's good. It's you got nothing to worry about. It's all good because your voice indicates stability, integrity, an ability to see truth, and kindness. You take care of people. You've got a big caretaker thing going on. So don't throw it away.
Damn, girl, you're good.
Yeah, I am good. Thank you. I suck at a lot of things. This is one of the things I'm kind of good at. Thanks. Thank you. I really appreciate that. Now, tell me a little. It's interesting. I feel like you might have. I can't tell if you have kids or not, so much for me being perfect. But I feel like.
I don't. But I work with kids.
Do not give up. Do not give up. It feels like you're either between relationships or that the poem I read earlier was something you could identify with because...
Right, that I'm in between relationships or...
Or that you're with somebody who doesn't appreciate you as you should be appreciated. Yes?
I've been single for a very long time, but there's two possible potential people that are interested in me at the moment. And I'm really
which
not...
Ones yeah. You're not interested in them?
I'm interested in them, but they're totally, completely different people to me.
Yeah.
And so I'm not sure if I trust either one of them.
You know, I would go with that and be, don't be... Remember that you can set your boundaries and you're in charge of the situation. So I think this is the more you trust and appreciate yourself right now, what you're doing, and I'm just putting my head up because I think it makes me look better. So it's nothing to do with you. The more you appreciate and really like yourself, which I think a lot of women who've been told that to be good people, we have to like always be hard on ourselves and always be critical of ourselves, like not like ourselves because that's conceited. But you know what? I'm all for like bragging rather than complaining. I'm all for like I really think that something that would be great for you is acknowledging to yourself how bloody cool you are. And
yeah, I do need to do that more.
Yeah, so I'm going to tell you to go out and get a little pretty notebook. Okay. Barnes & Noble has some ones and a pretty little pen. And there's an exercise that I recommend to clients that really works, but people get like scared to do it. But I'm going to ask you to give it a try, okay? So I want you to write down... Set the timer for 10 minutes and write down every compliment, like your family, your friends, your acquaintances, people like on the bus have given you. Start out with like your family, and it's going to be hard not to go into like, oh, they didn't appreciate me, but don't do that. So write down every compliment you've gotten and then read it out loud and listen to it in the morning and the evening. And if you do that for like 7 days straight. It's a great way. Tune in next week for our psychic lessons. But until then, it's a great way to just amp up your self-esteem and amp up your psychic power. Cool. Because that job wants. And there's a.
I think one of the.
Yeah, great. Is one of the guys a Pisces or a water sign?
Sorry, what?
Is one of the two guys a Pisces or a water sign?
Scorpio.
Oh, okay. That was what I'm getting. He's probably is a Pisces moon, though. I like him a little better. I know people say a lot of stuff about Scorpios, but I like him better for you.
I'm more attracted towards him, I feel.
What?
But he also, I'm more attracted to him physically.
Yes.
And I connect with him intellectually more.
Yeah.
But I also, there's something, well, like I said, that there's something that I distrust about each one of them. It's just, but I think a lot of that is just conditioned behavior of my past as well, to be very leery of certain people. And so I think that a lot of that distrust is my own distrust that I need to work through. And so I might be projecting that on both of those people.
Spot on. Because I, you know, the minute that you realize that everything is in your power, that that person really doesn't have the ability to hurt you. That's something I'd like you to think about this week. And we've only got a minute left. So, and thank you for calling in. And let me know what happened. Okay? And check out the Scorpio. All right.
I totally will. And thank you.
Sure. And go to my Facebook site, Peri Lyons, or Peri Lyons Skeptic, Peri Lyons Psychic for Skeptics and Smart People, and I'll post the Archangel Michael thing artwork for everybody out there to download. It's free, it's on me, and just rock on with your bad self.
Okay, well, thank you so much. And I so appreciated this. I needed this like nothing. Like, it was perfect divine timing for this to happen tonight. So thank you from the bottom of my heart.
You're welcome. Huge, huge hug. And so that's it for our show tonight. But thank you for dropping in on me, Peri Lyons, P-E-R-I, like Peri Winkle, Lyons, L-Y-O-N-S. And go to my website. We've got more videos up. I'm going to be the blog about how to be psychic. And I want to thank Dave Solomon and Constance Solomon, my fantastic producers. And thank all of you for just really being awesome. And I'd like to dedicate this show to my friend Suzanne. And that's it. So thank you, guys. Go to my website. I'll be putting up that artwork very soon for you to download for free.